In this tutorial, we are going to learn about the join or the joining tables and Cartesian product. Now, what do we mean by joining tables? A join is a query that combines rows from two or more tables. So, join means combining rows from two or more tables. The function of combining data. So, this function of combining data from multiple tables or two tables is called joining. The joining of two tables can be restricted based on some conditions or unrestricted. So, joining can be restricted or unrestricted. The next, unrestricted join or Cartesian product. So, a Cartesian product of two tables is a relation that combines all possible concatenations of both rows, of all rows of both the participating relations. It means that while doing a Cartesian product, all possible concatenations means joining of all rows, means a row from one table will combine with each and every row of the second table of both the participating relations, means both the table rows will combine with each other. Then a Cartesian product is formed when a Cartesian product is formed. A join condition is omitted, means we have omitted the join condition, and all rows in the first table are joined to all rows in the second table. So all rows from the first table are joined to all rows in the second table. Then the cardinality of a Cartesian product is the product of cardinalities of two tables, means here cardinality. So cardinality means the number of rows. So number of rows in the Cartesian product will be, suppose n1 into n2, where n1 and n2 are the cardinalities of the two participating tables. Suppose n1 is the number of tables in the first table, number of rows in the first table, and n2 is the number of rows in the second table. So then the cardinality of the join will be n1 into n2. Then next, degree. The degree of the Cartesian product is the sum of degrees of the participating tables. So means if we want to find the degree of the Cartesian product, then we have to find the sum of degrees of the participating tables. So we have learned that cardinality of the Cartesian product will be the product of the rows, number of rows of both the tables, and degree of the Cartesian product will be the sum of the columns of both the participating tables. So in this way we can find the Cartesian product of two tables. Now let's see an example. Now here, as you can see here, data have three rows and marksheet have also three rows. Now Cartesian product. So the statement for Cartesian product will be statement star means all columns from data, comma marksheet. So these are the tables. So as you can see here, there is no condition, there is no where clause. Now what will be the output here? As you can see here, 1 2 3, here also 1 2 3, it is first combining with the first row of the second table. Here as you can see 1 1 1, so means it is joined to the first row of the second table. Then again 1 2 3, here 1 2 3, means again rows from the first table. Then again they are joining with the second row of the second table. Then again 1 2 3, means table 1 data. Then again third row of the second table. So in this way, all rows from second or all rows from first table is joining with all rows from the second table. So in this way the Cartesian product is formed. Since the data table is first, so that's why it is combining first with the first row, then first second with the second row in this way. So if the marksheet table is written first and the data is written second, then the output will be 1 2 4, then 1 1 1, then again 1 2 4, then 1 1 1 over 2 2 2, then again 1 2 4, then 3 3 3. So So here the output of the Cartesian product will be degree is equal to 2 plus 3. Here since the columns are 2, here the 3, so therefore 2 plus 3, and the cardinality will be 3 into 3, that is 9. Thank you.